During yesterday's parliament sitting, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, announced the decision which was taken by Parliament's administration for a memorandum of understanding between Parliament and moneylenders. Tayewa noted that the decision was taken following embarrassing incidents where moneylenders harassed indebted legislators with high interest rates, which puts the image of the August House to disrepute.
We have had a story quoting the Speaker of Parliament in the media that there are MPs who are hiding from moneylenders. We need people to see their right to extend that investigation even to Parliament, because you also have read reports of MPs hiding in Parliament because of loans.
Parliament has its own procedures and mechanisms of handling such matters. One of the actions we managed to take was to suspend all moneylenders who were cutting off MPs' money directly from the platforms. We cancelled all the MOUs.
The decision has been welcomed by some legislators who claim the situation was getting out of hand as legislators were being chased by loan sharks on the streets. They believe the sanctity of the House is paramount to individual interests.
I think the Parliament wants to save its reputation, and particularly the Speaker would not be pleased to see members of Parliament being chased like chicken thieves by these moneylenders when they are asking for their money. It is true that because of the many demands that the members of Parliament have, they end up running to moneylenders. But Parliament has also created an avenue where we have a parliamentary circle where members can go and borrow money on terms that are favorable. And if members borrowed money from the parliamentary circle, chances are that they will not be chased like chicken thieves.
Well, yesterday the Speaker, in his communication, and that was instigated by someone's question, to even to extend the inquiry about the loan sharks to Parliament, which has become escalated, because you have seen many of our fellow colleagues in prison, and it's not only in prison in Rizera. We are in prison everywhere we go, even in villages. We are running away from people. So that is not a good indication of an honorable member of Parliament.
Legislators added that the new norm will instill financial discipline among MPs, saying some were borrowing out of excitement and pressure to finance less priority activities like buying alcohol for their constituents.
It makes the member of parliament to, you know, spend within their means so that we don't overspend the money we have and we don't overborrow. Because of borrowing, because of pressure from the constituencies, members of parliament have really borrowed until their payrolls are reading nil in their emoluments and salaries.
Whenever they come to offer this credit, they are so friendly. But when it comes to demanding this credit, they get outside the normal expected operational nature of being as friendly as possible, but also understanding the financial stressors that we go through. And this calls for rescheduling of these loans where necessary. You can reschedule the loans and also get assured, especially from those who are getting payments through their salaries, get the assurance that it will come.
However, a section of lawmakers have raised a red flag that cancelling Parliament's partnership with credit facilities is a mistake, which is going to make life difficult for lawmakers who are in dire need of money to provide to over-demanding constituencies.
It is proper. It is not proper at all. Any institution everywhere, even in our small institutions, you have to see that your workers, your staff are uplifted. They can be uplifted by getting small loans to advance what they cannot do. Everywhere. So the Speaker's decision, I think you need to go back and check it.
I think the Speaker and the commissioners need to go ahead and look for an alternative. By the time members of Parliament go outside there to borrow money from these money lenders, they don't have anything in their pockets because of the many demands.
Several MPs have recently found themselves in Luzira and other prisons as judgment debtors due to failure to settle their debt obligations with money lenders. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.